When a magnet quenches, all of the energy stored in that magnetic field rapidly collapses, and this induces high voltages into the coil structure. To prevent damage to the coil structure from localized heating, AMI incorporates protection diodes into your magnet. These protection diodes are a package of two diodes connected in anti-parallel, which is basically anode to cathode. Depending on the size of your magnet, you could have one diode package or you could have several. Now, these diode packages will fail almost exclusively after a quench. If you experience a quench and your magnet is no longer operating correctly, stop using it before you could cause permanent damage to the magnet and then start testing. In this video, we're going to go through the different tools you need to test diode packages while connected to the magnet and what to do with the readings you'll get. Let's go ahead and get started. It's common to want to grab a multimeter. They work for a lot of things, but they won't work for this. They put out a direct current, and that's going to go right through the coil in addition to the diode, and you're going to get a short every time. So don't use a multimeter because it's not going to give you the results you want. What you're going to want to use is a curve tracer. A curve tracer is going to send an AC current through the coil and the diode, and because of the high inductance of the coil, current will flow through the diode before the coil, which allows you to more or less isolate the current. This curve tracer is the octopus. It has several voltages that it works on, and it allows you to change the width of the AC signal leaving. It's going to basically take the current and voltage that it sees, and it connects to the X and Y of our oscilloscope here. You do need an oscilloscope that operates in XY mode. You can buy a curve tracer like the octopus as a kit, or as a download a schematic and build your own. Or if you want to, you may have in your lab a end-use product that is a curve tracer, just like this oscilloscope's an end-use product. So there's lots of options. Notice the x-axis, left and right, represents voltage, with 0 volts in the center. As the curve trace output sweeps from negative to positive, any voltage seen in the load will show left to right. Notice the y-axis, up and down, represents current, with 0 amps in the center. As current flows through the load, the trace will graph a vertical deflection. With a resistive load, such as a resistor or a light bulb, we can expect the trace to look like this. Notice the linear relationship between voltage and current. The more voltage, the more current. A negative voltage on the left side of the axis creates a negative current on the bottom side of the axis. With an open circuit, the leads not connected to anything, we'll see a full sweep of voltage with no current deflection. With a shorted circuit, leads connected to each other, we will see a full deflection of current with hardly any voltage being developed. Finally, with a diode, we will see no current until the diode switches on, but we'll see a transition when this happens. Here's a 20-year-old magnet we had in storage. It has one diode and a persistent switch, and the rest of these are all lugs. The lugs are connecting all the different coils of the magnet together, and they can be identified because from the lug, the wires go down to the coil. On a diode, the wire will go down to two other lugs. So this is our diode, and we have a lug wire going over to this one and another wire going to that one. Notice it doesn't go directly down to the coil. Some other lugs on newer magnets will have a hex head on top, and the diode will not. Depends what magnet you have on exactly how it looks. Here's a more modern diode package. I got this from the line. It's the same exact thing, only in a different package. You have diodes inside of this and two long leads. So when everything gets installed, these are shortened and insulated. So right here I have shorted connection. We see we have current deflecting immediately without any change in voltage because it's a short. If we were to try to stretch that out very wide, we would see it very slightly showing some deflection left and right. But the voltage is so low, it's going to be hard to see. Here's the same setup with an open. See, there's no vertical deflection because there's no current flowing. There's no connection. Now, if we have a diode package that's on its own outside of a magnet, Our setup will look something like this. Notice how we have to wait until we reach so far horizontally, we have to reach so much voltage before current starts to flow, which they turn on and start to conduct. And you can see here that the voltage is equal on both sides. We've gone through and looked at a short, then an open, and then a properly functioning diode package. Here I have a failed diode package. This one I put too much current through at room temperature and caused it to fail. You can see on this diode package that there is some sooty, sticky residue coming out of the epoxy. Now this is almost always indicative of a failed diode. And it's important to remember that your eyes and your nose can be just as helpful as the curve tracer. So don't forget that. Now when we hook this diode up, you'll see in addition to the fact that it looks and smells damaged, that we're not getting the trace we expect. What we would expect is voltage to increase to reach the knee voltage around 0.5 or 0.6 volts, and then current to quickly increase after that point. This would happen both in the positive direction and the negative direction. Instead, as soon as we get any voltage, current starts to flow in both the positive direction and the negative direction. This is indicative of a resistive behavior, which is what you see in a shorted diode. Now, don't confuse this with the short I showed you earlier, which this short right here, I'm touching the leads together, is a 0 ohm short, which is very, very steep. Just like how an infinite ohm open is very, very horizontal. So here's our small magnet that I showed you earlier. It has a persistent switch and a diode. The diode's in parallel to the entire coil, as is the persistent switch. This one is more or less a worst case scenario because the persistent switch has a very small inductance and a very small resistance, and it allows a lot of current to flow around the diode, even with a curve tracer. So I'm going to clip on to each lead coming out of the diode. And you see here, it's a little bit different than our textbook definition we had earlier, because this represents the current flowing through that very low inductance switch. This also can happen in any low inductance coil. We can see, however, that we have an increase in current along with voltage, looking fairly resistive, and then there is a definite transition point where current increases greatly. And that's what we're looking for when we're testing diodes. Here's a magnet that is still older, but it has the modern diode package. If you look at these diode packages, you have two wires coming into each one. Simply take your curve tracer leads, whatever they may be, and go across each diode. And to do that, be able to test each diode one by one as you go around the magnet. If you notice that on this magnet, we have, without a persistent switch, a much more textbook example of what the curve tracer shows us. We don't have that resistive increase in current as voltage gets closer to tripping the diodes. So right here I've gone on the same lead twice and we're getting a short. So I just need to move what lead I'm coming off of here where I can get a good test on this one. So come off over here. Another good diode. So that's the basics of testing diode packages while they're connected to your magnet. If you're having trouble finding all your diodes, or if you're having trouble interpreting curve tracer information, contact us at support@americanmagnetics.com. Just include the serial number and screenshots or pictures of any relevant traces, and we'll be happy to help.